Slack communities are a great way to connect with like-minded peers, coworkers, and teams. And in this video, we'll take a look at what Slack is and how to use some of its best features. Slack is a real-time messaging app that's very popular in the corporate space. So internal teams use it to communicate with each other, teams use it to communicate with external partners, and also communities of practice or professional communities use Slack as a place to come together, share resources, and help one another. So today we're going to be looking at how to use some of Slack's core features, and we're going to be looking at that in context of this instructional design and e-learning community that I've started and I've been growing. So let's take a look at it together. So here we are in the Slack desktop app, and I do want to point out that if you're using Slack, you should really download the app on your computer and on your phone. It just makes it easier to have all of your communication in one place and easier to access notifications and things like that. So let's start by looking over here on the far left. This panel right here is where you can access the different communities that you may be a part of. So whenever you join a community, you'll be asked to create like a login for that specific community. But every login that's tied to your email address, like those communities will show up over here. And if you want to sign into a new community or what Slack calls a workspace, you can just use this plus button to continue adding them and to access them all easily from one place. So right here, we are looking at this Devlin Peck community. The next panel we're looking at is these are all the different channels and messages that these are the different threads where you would go to communicate with people. So you see right here this channels section. These are going to be the different topics essentially where you would go to communicate about that topic. So you see here we have discussed general instructional design. This is where people would talk about general instructional design things. If we go to the social introductions channel, this is where people introduce themselves. So it's quite self-explanatory. And sometimes when you join a Slack community, there may be additional channels you can join that you aren't in by default. So I bring everyone into these channels by default, but if you're in a community where you only see a couple of channels, press this add a channels button and see what else is available. Also, there are direct messages. So if you ever want to direct message someone, you can just click on their photo and you can press message and it will just start up a new direct message conversation with them. And you can say, you can have those private conversations. So if the community is on a free plan, then the messages will only be available, only the 10,000 most recent messages will be available. Slack's pricing isn't the most friendly for like these communities of practice because you need to pay per month per member. So there is a bunch of cool functionality that opens up when you are on a paid plan, but for a community like this where there's over 1,000 people in it right now, it doesn't make sense for me as like a content creator to be paying $7 a month per person. But the free features are enough. It lets you have this real-time communication with people, and the app functions obviously really well. So once you are in one of these channels that we can see on the left, there are obviously this message right here is where we can actually type out a message and send it, and there are formatting options so we can use bulleted lists and all of those fun things. But when we want to respond to someone, it may be tempting to just respond to it right here in the message box, but if you're responding in direct relation to another person's message, you can respond in a thread. So as you can see here, Sierra introduced herself, and then you can see that this is a thread, and there's an option if we click on these two replies to view the thread. So when you click on that, it opens it up, and it will look very similar on mobile as well. You will see that there are additional messages in response to this primary message. So if you want to add on to the thread, first you can click here to view it, and then you can type something new in this little text box. But if the thread doesn't already have anything on it, like this message right here, what we can do is when you mouse over this, you will see these different icons. This first one is to add a reaction. This is how you can add different emojis. So you can see here people have like the waving hand emoji. And you can react with any kind of emoji you'd like. But this one right here, this reply in thread option that looks like a little speech bubble, a message bubble, that's how you actually open it up in this thread view and can respond in direct response to another message. So that is very important. If you're on mobile, you can also access that reply in thread by like long pressing on the message and you'll get that reply in thread option. That's a great way to just keep the communication organized and to help people choose which conversations they'd like to read more about instead of like really crowding up a channel with in response to one specific message. So those are the basics. If you know about how to access the different workspaces or communities to bounce around to the different ones you might be a part of, that's good. Once you're in a community, you want to go to the specific channel that's related to the topic you're discussing. And then once you're in there, make sure you take advantage of that thread feature to keep the communication organized. So I hope that was helpful. If you would like to join this e-learning and instructional design Slack community, I'll drop a link right below this video. And if you have any other questions about Slack or specific functionality within Slack, feel free to drop a comment and I will do my best to help you out. So thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.